Welcome back to Let's Play the Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword. Last time we completed the Lanayru mining facility, gained the harp. And today we were told by Impa to go back to the old woman in the forest. And we're gonna do that. As to be more of the unknown variety, just heading back to the Faron province, mainly because we have to talk to the old woman again, much as I really don't want to. We don't have much choice in the matter. And if we can just fall a little bit faster. I'm amazed one sailcloth can bring two grown men down safely. Granted, a small bruise is here and there, but not that bad of a landing.
I think I might have broke something. Hey Link, seriously, didn't anyone ever teach you how to not crash a boat?
Tiny birds.
Birds! Tiny birds! What are they?
They're birds.
And what is that thing?
That's a Goron.
But how? What? Where am I? What's going on here? Ever since Zelda vanished, you've been zipping in and out of town in a hurry. So I figured I'd tell you, it might lead me to Zelda. But this is so wild! Seriously, what is that thing over there?
What's up with these trees? There are so many!
Just give it to me straight! I can take it! Where are we? Where is Zelda here? What's the deal with this place? If there's something to be nothing below the clouds, what's all this?
Calm yourself, Grace. Calm yourself and let him explain everything. I have a headache.
Whoa. You're kind of imploding my mind right now. But I think I get what you're saying. If I've got this right, Zelda is down here somewhere, and she's okay.
Yep, pretty much.
She's okay. Oh, wow. That's so great. Hearing that is such a huge weight off my mind.
You crying? You're crying.
You know, Link, it's sort of alright down here.
I guess so. It's not too bad with all the monsters about.
This place needs a name. Yeah, a name fitting for this rugged, adventurous wilderness. From now on, we'll call it Grooseland.
No. Just no, Groose. No.
So let me see if I got this right. The old lady living in this temple down the road here knows where Zelda is. I see. Right. Link, thanks for getting me down here. You've done a good job. You can head home. Big Goose will handle the search for Zelda from here. Yep, I'll track her down, save her, and then give her a lift back to Skyloft. Then when we get back, I'll ask her if she wants to make our whole going out thing official, and then the two of us will get some quality time together. Anyway, the point is your work here is done. I got it covered from here. Now, it's all to find that old lady you were talking about.
What?
Catch you later, Link!
What's going on? He wasn't supposed to be here. Gonna catch me some birds. and I catch me some birds. I got a bird and I got a feather for my troubles. I haven't played this game in a while. My memory is all so hazy now. However, I know what roughly we have to do, so I'm just gonna climb up here. And we're gonna head on into the temple. Because we have to talk to the old lady and see what the heck's going on with her and Groose. Because Groose be crazy. Huh? You gotta be kidding me, Granny! You're messing with me! Say it again! I dare you! I only speak the truth. You're not the one who will save her. The Spirit Maiden, your Zelda, can only be saved by another. It has been his fate to do this thing, and in doing so, save us, as it was decided long before you were brought crying into this world. Shut it, Granny! You obviously don't know me well, because if you did, you know anybody's gonna save Zelda. It's Groose. How could it not be me? Plus, if it ain't me, why would I even be here? If I'm not up to the job of being a hero, just who is? Huh? Hey, what's up? I missed something? Oh, now I getcha. Link, Granny here has been trying to tell me that you're gonna be the big hero who rescues Zelda. What a joke! Look, all I've heard is so far a bunch of babbling about destiny, but that's a load of garbage. I know you, and you're no hero, shrimp. You go cry, Groose.
Greetings, Link. Were you able to catch up with Zelda? Ah, I see. So the Guardian was there as well, was she? I figured you would know that. The one you saw by Zelda's side is known as Impa. She is a being sent forth by the goddess to aid Zelda in her quest. The two have traveled somewhere in order to accomplish the great task destiny has set before them. However, now that Impa has destroyed the gate that they used, there is only one way left to find them. You must make use of the harp given to you by Zelda. Tell me, Link, have you attempted to play the harp that you have received? My sense is that you have not familiarized with it yet.
Well, I've tried using it, but I can't carry a tune.
Very well. I shall teach you how to play it. Listen well and do as I say.
Yes, ma'am. For your next lesson, focus in a circle, make a circle of light, blah blah blah, timing's just right, I shall join my voice with your harp. Okay.
Harp playing while sitting down is a pain. We learned the ballad of the goddess. The goddess, so much of the goddess in this game. Point being, we learn a song and a giant tablet appears. That's a relief. Giant tablet.
The harp you hold is known as the goddess's harp. It is the divine instrument of the goddess who once watched over this land. The melodies it brings to life have the power to produce a variety of strange and otherworldly effects. The great slab standing before you is known as the Gate of Time. It is the last of its kind in existence, the only portal binding our world to the one where Zelda resides now. If you manage to open the gate and pass through, you will likely end up in the same place as Zelda. But you will need to endure many hardships and put yourself in great danger to awaken the gate from its dormant state. Though your journey will put you through harm's way, Link, you must endure. It is your fate as the chosen hero of the god.
I don't think we should be worrying about that.
The shaking. I fear the seal has broken. I expected that it would react to your summoning the gate, but I never imagined the seal would break so quickly.
Well, wasn't like on the verge of breaking when we first got here? Right, time to hurry outside, and the shortcut behind us is now gone. Gotta run around the giant slab, and I hate that so much. Just taking up space, that slab. Oh well. This can only mean one thing. Boss time! We just finished a boss like two parts ago. Or a part ago. Yay, boss time! Link, why you gotta stand still? Oh, hey, Groose.
Whoa, what's with the shaking? The whole ground is heaving. I thought it was supposed to be solid down here.
Go, quickly, Link. Check on the ceiling spike at the center of the pit. There is nothing natural about these tremors. The monster could free itself at any moment. Approach the pit with caution.
Caution, eh? You mean jumping off the cliff? Sure, let's go! That's what I do. I just run down. Then again, it's the fastest way down there and it saves time. You don't have to press the actual button to hold it. Just lightly tap it and you don't have to worry about fall damage. Oh my, look at all that darkness. Oh hi! I remember you. I've had nightmares about you. None that were pleasant. Not a single one. The Imprisoned! Round one! Fight! Essentially, that's pretty much it is right now. It's round one, fight. Have a good time. Explain later, but right now we have to keep it from escaping. I'll toss what she means by this. Go up to the top of it and hit its head. Or hit its feet, make it fall over. Either way you can do, which I'm going to do the easy way and just hit its head. Well, for the meanwhile, this is the easy way, hitting its head. Just where is that thing's head? There it is. Over here, judging from here. Let's go. That's one hit down, and now knocked on down. Thankfully, Link's smart enough to use the sailcloth without us pressing a button, and now it's going to roll along the floor like a snake. I'm going to have to go up here. Now, where is it? There it is. Every time it gets out of its little crawling of the ground phase, it's going to initiate a little mini cutscene, bringing the ceiling spike back out of its head, initiating the second part of the fight, meaning you have to hit back inside its head, which isn't too difficult. The Imprisoned, the first time around, isn't that terrible of a boss fight. It's... what the? Am I seeing this right? He glitched through the floor! What nonsense is this? That never happened before! That was not supposed to happen. But it did. But you know what? I'll take it. It kept him from going closer to the temple, which is fine by me. He just clipped through the solid objects. With a headache induced from caffeine withdrawal, so I think this is a nice time to have a good laugh. However, with that, the fight's over. Oh, that last bit was really unexpected there. I wasn't expecting him to just go clip through the floor. That was awesome. And then he explodes in a shining light. So that works. Rather, that's something. He explodes, expands, then compresses back together. I don't know, it looks cool, that's all I can say. Right, now we gotta hit the ceiling spike with the Skyward Strike again, just like before, when we first got here. Yes, Impa, wait, no, Link, wait, no, Link, you fool. Let's go hit that thing. Just let me have the seal. 1, 2, 3. Yay, triangles of justice! Stay down! Well, that was certainly anticlimactic of a boss fight. That didn't take too long. So, Groose, you still think I can't handle it? Nice going, Link. Though the imprisoned had only just begun to awaken and break its bonds, I'm impressed you're able to restore the seal, keeping it captive. Unfortunately, you have only succeeded in buying us a little more time in which to act. The behemoth you have beat back into the confinement is a horror of unspeakable power. Judging by what I saw, I would not be surprised if the seal gave way again soon. So you are left with precious little time to complete the task which you have been entrusted. Return to the sealed temple, Link. There is much to discuss. Now my question is, do I keep this all in one part or do I just split it from here? Well, either way, it gets done, so it doesn't really matter. Guess we're keeping it in then. As you can see, the gate is nothing more than a slab of cold stone for now. It is sleeping. Rousing it from its slumber would require great power. Yes, I believe a shot of holy light from your Skyward Strike might just do it. Ah, sorry to disappoint you, boy, but for now your sword lacks the power necessary to awaken the gate. First, you and your sword must grow together. Faron Woods, Elden Volcano, and the Nehru Desert. A sacred flame is hidden somewhere in each of these lands. Seek them out, and purify your soul in their heat. Only after your blade has been tempered by these three fires will it be fully imbued with the great power for which you seek. Clues to finding the sacred flames have been woven into the lyrics of some precious of a song precious to your people, the Ballad of the Goddess. These clues are your best hope of finding your way to the flames. Return to Skyloft. Somewhere on your island is one whose knowledge of the old song will point you in the direction.
I hate even saying this, but I guess you got it all figured out, Granny. Me? Well, there's nothing I can do to help Zelda. I'm useless.
Ah, you sell yourself short, my friend. You'll see in time that you have your own role to play in all this. Link, go now. Trust in fate to guide your feet. Your mission depends on it, as does Zelda's fate.
Like I have a choice in the matter?
Wow.
Right, and with that, we're gonna head outside real quick. We're gonna head outside, Link, not run up a wall. We're not doing parkour this part. We're gonna head back up to the sky and then head back to Skyloft. Or we can just head back to Skyloft now and then. That might actually be easier, but however, we'll just call it a day for now and see you all next time on Let's Play The Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword.